Hello students, today in this lecture we will continue our session in the chapter 4 by discussing about bend saw, circular saw and the saw blades and the terminology of these saw blades. So let us start with our first topic, that is the bend saw. And as we have discussed in our previous lecture, this bend saw is ribbon like structure in which if we say this type of bend is available and over which these cutting teeth are available. And as it rotates, with the rotation when it comes into contact with the workpiece, it starts removing material and that is how cutting action is obtained. So there are certain advantage of using this bend saw compared to the regular hacksaw in which reciprocating motion is available. So this bend saw employs a continuous action of endless high speed tooth blade because over its entire periphery all the tools are available, and as it is rotating, this operation is called as the endless cutting operation. So the major advantage of using this bend saw the first one is its cutting speed is twice to that of the hacksaw blade used. And the second one is it can cut irregular curves in metals very easily, because in the case of hacksaw blade it is necessary that it will cut only straight path only. That means straight cutting is only and only possible in the case of the hacksaw blade, whereas in the case of the bend saw irregular curves can also be cut very easily. There are certain limitations also of using this bend saw, from which as it consists of the many number of teeth and as it is rotating, the formation of the bend saw blade is comparatively difficult, so it may result into the higher cost compared to the hacksaw blade available. So now we will discuss about the different types of bend saw machines are available. So from them, first one, that is the vertical bend saw. And now as the name suggests, you will come to know that this vertical bend saw has such an arrangement in which it will remove the material from vertical direction. So let us have a look at the simple 2D figure of this vertical bend saw. So as you can see, in the case of this vertical bend saw, this first part, that is the column, and this column supports all the elements available in the case of this vertical bend saw. Similarly, the second part, that is the head, and this head is consist of the main power transmission element, or we can say as the motor. And this machine consists of the two wheels. The first one is the upper wheel and the second one shown over here, that is the lower wheel. And on the rims available, this blade rotates, and this blade is shown over here. So the rotation of this blade will help us to remove the material. And the next part shown over here, it is called as the guide, and this guide helps to hold and support the workpiece which is fixed. So if we see this figure comparatively from another side, suppose if we say this is the workpiece available and we want to cut material from this particular portion and we want to cut this dashed section, then what happens? This section is fed towards the machine available, and when it is fed inside and set up to this certain portion, then this blade continuously starts rotating, and the rotation of which starts removing material from the surface available over here. And as the feed is provided, slowly the material is removed from the workpiece and this block is obtained as a separate portion from the original workpiece available. As you can see, as it starts rotating, due to the rotation of which this blade rotates, and the rotation of blade results into the removal of material from the workpiece. So this is the simple arrangement for the case of this vertical bend saw. So some of the application of vertical bend saw is it is useful for cutting of the sprues and riser from the castings. Then it is also useful for making dies or tools. And filing, polishing the contours of regular or irregular shapes, and also straight internal or external and angular cutting is performed with the help of this vertical bend saw. So these are the some common applications of using this vertical bend saw. Now we will discussion about horizontal bend saw. So let us have a look at simple figure of this horizontal bend saw. Now as you can see, in the case of this horizontal bend saw, two wheels are available. First one is driven wheel, another one is the driver wheel, and the motor is connected to this driver wheel, which automatically helps to rotate this driven wheel. Now when this driver wheel rotates, with help of this driven wheel also rotates, and on the periphery of which the cutting band, that is the saw band, is connected, which helps to remove the material. Now at the another portion, as you can see, adjustable supports and saw guides are provided, which are helpful to adjust the workpiece available as per the shape and size of different workpieces. Now similarly, the operation is same to that of the vertical bend saw. When this bend saw rotates and the workpiece is set as per requirement, it starts removing material from the workpiece and cut off the parts required that we have set. So this is the basic arrangement for the case of horizontal bend saw. Similarly, the next one, that is the circular saw. And for the case of circular saw, let us have a look at the figure shown over here. You can see over here, the workpiece is set over here on the work holding devices, that is the V block. As you can see, the workpiece is circular, and to hold the circular workpieces, in many of the cases these V blocks are used. So another part shown over here, that is the clamp. And this clamp is arranged and it is moved in downward direction properly fixing this workpiece between this V block and the clamp. And that is why the removal of workpiece is very easy in the case of the circular saw. So as you can see, in the case of circular saw, the saw available is in the case of circular disc, and the teeth available are shown over here in the case of this circular saw. Now when the cutting needs to be performed, this circular saw is fed in forward direction, and as the workpiece available over here, this circular saw comes into the contact of this workpiece, and as it moves in the upward direction, it starts removing material from the workpiece. And as it's fed towards the workpiece, as it reaches up to the another end available of the workpiece, is entirely removes the material from the workpiece, and it cut off the circular workpieces very easily. And as you can see, this circular saw is rotating with higher speed, so it can remove the material from the workpiece very easily. And as per the workpiece available, it may be a soft workpiece or it may be a brittle workpiece, different material of the circular saws are used. So depends on the material available, the material of the circular saw is selected. So the arrangement is shown over here, and remaining cutting operation is similar, just the shape available of the saw is different other than the discussed one. So if we summarize, in the case of the hexo blade, the arrangement is straight steel ruler type arrangement. In the case of bend saw, the arrangement is like ring stripe arrangement, or we can say that one type of bend is available on the periphery of which teeth are available. And similarly, the last one, that is the circular saw, and in the case of circular saw, the teeth are available on the periphery of the blade, and which helps to remove the material. So now we have discussed about the major important different types of saw, that is the reciprocating saw, bend saw, and the circular saw. So now I hope that you have the clarity about these different types of saws available and when these different types of saws are useful. So now let us discuss about the saw blades and how these saw blades are made and what are the important terminologies available in these saw blades. So first, let us have a look at this simple zoom view of this blade. As you can see, this is the depth of the tooth, and that's why this distance is called as the depth of tooth. So it is called as the depth of the tooth. The second parameter that one can see, the distance between two similar tooth, this distance is called as the pitch. And this is nothing but the distance between the two consecutive teeth available. The next important parameter, that is, you can see over here, this is the back portion of the tooth and it is called as the back. And similarly, as you can see, this part is the front face and that why it is called as the face. And this face is the main bearing element in the saw blades, because this face directly comes into the contact that the chips removed during the machining operation. Because as the chip removed, it is directly impact on the face, and face needs to be major bearing element, as if it cannot sustain the load that is imparted by the chips formed, then it may result into the failure of that particular tooth. So these are the main major parts available in the case of the saw blades. And the other parts available, that are, as you can see over here, the gap is available, which helps to remove the chips that are formed during machining process. So this particular portion is called as the gullet. So this is called as the gullet, and it helps to remove the chips from the particular cutting section. Now, up to now, we have listed, first one is depth of tooth, next one, that is the pitch, another one is face, next one is flank, and another one, that is the gullet. And what are the meaning of these, that we have also understood. Now there are two major angles are also available which helps to remove the material. So the first angle that you can see, as you can see, the teeth are inclined in this particular direction, that means during forward stroke it will remove material very easily. So if we see the angle that is made with the horizontal by the back of this tooth, then this angle is called as the clearance angle. So this angle is the clearance angle. Similarly, if we say this face, this particular face, as we see, let us draw another time. If we see this face makes certain angle with the horizontal axis, and this angle is nothing but the rake angle for this particular tool. So these are the different angles also available in the case of the saw blades. So this is the basic terminology of saw blades and which are the important parts available. Now, as you can see, these teeth are, or multiple teeth are available on this blade, and there are variable arrangements are also available for the different types of blades. So let us see the different types of arrangement available in the saw blades. The first arrangement, as you can see, the teeth are arranged in, first one is in downward direction, another one is in upward direction, downward direction, upward direction. So this type of arrangement, if the teeth is available, then this type of the blades are called as the straight set blades. And these blades are useful to remove the material from the workpieces, such as made of brass. And the another part that we can say it as, it will remove the material from copper and plastic also. That means these straight set blades are useful to remove the material if it is made of the brass, copper and plastic materials. Similarly, if you can see in the second set, which is called as the raker set, in which the teeth arrangement is like, first teeth is set downward, another one is straight teeth, next one is the upward teeth, and this sequence is repeated in the another teeth available or the set of teeth available. And this type of teeth is helpful to remove the material from the workpiece which are made of steel and iron materials. So this is another arrangement. And if the teeth are available, such as if you can see the teeth are first set on upward direction, then straight direction, then downward direction. So if we form, this is made like waveform, and that's why this last arrangement is called as the wavy set. And this wavy set is also helpful during different types of material used. And this wavy set is helpful to remove the material from the different types of hollow tubes and different sheets of the metal during cutting operation. So based on the requirement available, maybe a straight set teeth, maybe a raker type set teeth, or maybe a wavy set type teeth are used based on if it is applicable in a horizontal machine. Maybe if we say it is a reciprocating type machine, maybe it is a rotary or a circular saw machine, or if it is a bend saw machine. So based on the requirement and the raw material available, as per that, these different sets are used to remove the material and which are helpful to cut the material during machining operations. So I hope you have got the clarity about different types of sewing machines are available or sewing blades are available and different types of sets available and their application during machining operations. So looking forward to see you all in our next lecture. Up to then, thank you.